Hi everyone, Dr. Carri here from Recharge Therapy, and I am a pelvic floor therapist in Long Beach, California, and we're going to talk today about kegels in male patients. This also, I would say, applies to females, any gender, the rules apply, but two main reasons I see male patients in my clinic for pelvic floor issues. Number one is pelvic pain, and if you're having pelvic pain, and again, this applies to females as well as males, but if you're having pelvic pain, kegels are not for you. No kegels. If you're having pelvic pain, that means there's probably tightness somewhere around the pelvic floor muscles, and so we don't need to make those muscles tighter by doing kegels. So that's number one. Number two, I see patients often, my male patients come in for incontinence after they've had prostate surgery. And to be honest, in my experience, that's pretty much the only time I've seen males for incontinence is after prostate surgery. And yes, they need to do kegels. So start practicing your kegels. Oftentimes now the surgeon will send them to pelvic floor therapy for like one visit prior to surgery, which I think is great. You can learn how to use these muscles when you're not recovering from surgery. So then hopefully it's better and easier to work on them after surgery. Those are the two main male clientele I see for pelvic floor therapy. The other thing I see on occasion, not as often, but constipation. So constipation, if you've had your gut checked out, you've been to the GI doctor, constipation can be a pelvic floor issue too. And often if it's pelvic floor involvement, the muscles are too tight. So when we poop and when we pee, like if this is the pelvic floor, things need to relax and open so the pee and the poop can pass through. So again, you would fall in that category of tight pelvic floor muscles, so no kegels. So basically, only do kegels if you're a male patient, if you have incontinence after surgery. I can't say I've had any male patients that have incontinence without having surgery. Sometimes there's other bladder issues like urinary frequency, like I'm going to the bathroom a lot, I feel like I always have to go, or sometimes shy bladder, but those often are still in the too tight category. So no kegels for you. Only incontinence, if you're a male, any other condition, pelvic floor condition, no kegels for you. Pelvic pain, constipation, bladder urgency, bladder hesitancy, no kegels. So got it? Males, kegels only if you have incontinence after surgery. No other scenario. Because of the anatomy of male patients, you only have a poop hole. So you very, very infrequently have weakness in the pelvic floor. It's so much more common to have tightness, okay? So when are we gonna do kegels to my men out there? Only with incontinence after surgery. Any other condition, you probably have tightness. We can explore that in another video. You probably need to do more stretching, breathing exercises. So, got it? No kegels for men except for incontinence. I'm just gonna repeat that 100 times. And anyway, that's it. Leave me a comment below if you wanna know more, different topics you wanna know about. And you can see me virtually if you want, if you're not local to California. Virtual visits, obviously I'm not looking at pelvic floors, but we can assess other movements, we can talk through what's happening and give you a direction at least to start in if it's not everything. All right, I'm Dr. Carri Dominic, pelvic floor therapist at Recharge Therapy.